Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Current Royale version 22 update is now finished. Let's get right into the showcase. But before we do that, I'd like to remind you all of the LTM contest. You can submit an LTM to be featured and played in a future update of Current Royale. You'll also get a shoutout. As long as you don't spam submissions, don't copy other people's ideas, and keep things appropriate, you may win. There's a link to the Google form in the description, as well as the comments. You can also make a submission in the comments, just be sure to specify what game rules and mechanics you want in the LTM. There's no exact end date yet, I plan to keep this open until I get at least a few submissions, which at the moment I have none, so better make your submissions sooner than later. Now, onto the showcase. Let's start off with some small gameplay changes and fixes. The elevator button that leads down to the basement now works properly, so you can go down there and explore the newly changed basement. More on that later. Harvest rate has been increased by 50%, meaning it'll take 2/3 as long to harvest as many materials as the previous update. Vault locks now take 3 seconds to open instead of opening instantly. You won't be able to just zip in and grab your loot now, watch your back. Weapon structural damage has been bumped back up to 50%. Still not 100%, but shooting through walls during a box fight will now be easier. This change may be reverted though, as the main reason structural damage was decreased was to deter players from shooting each other down while bridging across islands. Some weapons now have extra weight in the loot pool, meaning you'll be able to find them more often now. These include the standard assault rifle, sideways rifle, mechanical bow, pistol, dual pistols, pump shotgun, tactical shotgun, hunting rifle, submachine gun, and rapid fire SMG. Now on to map changes. A mysterious spaceship has appeared on the south side of the map. Let's hope it's screw our friendly. All named locations now have extra chests, particularly Neo Tower and Split Studio. Down Hope Hospital, the basement has been filled up a bit more, with lots of stuff stored down there, including a couple new chests. Up in Drifting Towers, the small bear we saw hanging over the ledge in the last update has been pulled up to safety. Though to the west in Split Studio, one of the trucks has now started falling off. I don't think it's light enough to recover from that. That's all the main map changes. Besides that, there are a couple things deleted, such as various props and a couple ammo case spawns to conserve memory, but anyway, let's now get on to Cold Crater. This update, Cold Crater got a loot overhaul. All old chests, ammo boxes, and vending machines, at least all that I could find, were removed and now replaced with new custom containers with a new loot pool. There are now also more buried treasure spots around the map, and searching them take a shorter amount of time, making them a more valuable loot source. Some fiends have been permanently killed off last gameplay video, so there is now one less spawner on the map, but fiends now have an increased chance of dropping loot, from 10% to 15%. Other than that, the fog around the map has faded a bit, but there is now some nicer snow effects around the map, and at Cave Under the Cliff, the ice continues to melt. Now onto some LTMs. The first LTM we have is Deathmatch. Players fight to get the most eliminations within 5 minutes. Respawns are infinite, and spawn loot is randomized, but potentially powerful. Just don't accidentally eliminate yourself, or you'll lose score. Next in Cold Crater, we have the Sneaky Silencers LTM. It's just regular Battle Royale, but with suppressed weapons only. With reduced visibility, sneaking up on an opponent is easier than ever. Can't find anyone? Just use a recon scanner, flare gun, or vendetta flopper to reveal where they're hiding. And finally, another Cold Crater LTM, Zone Wars. Again, regular Battle Royale, but players start off in a box with a random loadout of rare or better guns. Storm starts off a lot smaller and moves and shrinks much more frequently, forcing players into close quarters. Build to survive. Again, there's an LTM contest open now for a future update of Variant Royale that anyone can submit. Link in the description and comments. That's all for this video, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Goodbye.